everyone, Jesse here at the fort. You're about to meet my very good friend, Mr. Brown. He loves science, and I'm excited for you to learn and discover new things with him too. Have fun!
Hi, Webb. Do you know when you're going to be ready to play today?
I'm just about ready, and I have a great idea about what to do.
No way! I had an idea too. Let's say them at the same time. One, two, three.
Let's build a cardboard boat! Wow, we were thinking the same thing. I came up with a plan to make a big, strong boat with lots of tape and glue. It will look kind of plain, but there's no way it'll sink.
Oh, my plan was to make a small boat with a bunch of decorations, like a big striped sail and paint and maybe ribbon.
No way! I don't want to spend a bunch of time decorating a small boat.
Well, I don't want to make a big, boring boat either.
Let's do it my way.
Never!
Quack, 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 quack. Well, there's only one thing to do.
Let's go talk to Mr. Brown.
So you see, Mr. Brown, we don't know what to do. Which boat should we build?
Thanks for asking, you two. This is definitely a challenge. But you know what this reminds me of that might help? Mutualisms.
What's a mutualism? Is that a kind of animal?
Not quite. But it can involve animals. Mutualisms are when two living things work together to help each other. Those living things might be two animals, or a plant and an animal, or even another combination. But let's focus on animals for right now. In a mutualism, each animal has a special talent or talents, and they use those talents to help their partner. The animals aren't necessarily friends, and they're not the same kind of animal. So Bill and Webb, since you're siblings, and both ducks, you couldn't be in mutualism. But I do think you could learn a thing or two from them about how to work together.
Okay, I want to learn more.
Sure. Well, there are lots of examples out there, but I can tell you about some of my favorites. One of my favorite examples of a mutualism is between clownfish and sea anemone. Clownfish are small fish that live in the ocean, and they normally have orange, black, and white stripes. And this is a sea anemone. It might look like a plant, but it's actually an animal. It has wiggling tentacles with lots of stingers, and in the middle of those tentacles is a mouth. Anemone eat things like fish, crab, or shrimp, and they spend most of their lives stuck in the same spot. But here's the cool thing. Clownfish live inside the sea anemone, surrounded by its tentacles. The anemone's stingers don't bother the clownfish, but they can hurt other animals. So if any other fish shows up that wants to hurt the clownfish, it can just swim inside its home and let the sea anemone protect it. Meanwhile, the clownfish can chase away any other animals that might want to hurt the sea anemone. But clownfish also have another talent, their poop. Clownfish poop has important nutrients in it, which are things like vitamins and minerals that help plants and animals grow. So, when the clownfish poop near the sea anemone, their nutrients can help the anemone get bigger and stronger. So, both animals have a special skill, and they can use that skill to help their partner. That's how mutualisms work.
That makes sense. So, do mutualisms only happen with underwater animals?
Good question, Bill. Mutualisms can happen in all kinds of places, from the water to the land. In fact, another one of my favorite examples includes two animals that both live on land, coyotes and badgers. Badgers are found all over the world. They have fuzzy bodies, big claws, and most have striped faces. They live in tunnels underground and are usually only awake at night. Badgers like to eat worms, but they also will eat just about anything else. Coyotes are related to dogs and wolves, and they look a lot like them too. They have pointy ears, walk on all four legs, and have big fluffy tails. Like badgers, they're also normally awake at night, or in the very early morning or late evening. And also like badgers, they'll eat just about anything, but their favorite food is meat. Another thing about coyotes is that they're great runners. They can run super fast, which helps them chase down the animals they want to eat. So, when a coyote pairs up with a badger, that's how the coyotes help. They can chase down food that the badger isn't fast enough to get.
So, what do the badgers do?
I was getting to that. But what do you think they do, Webb?
Well, you said they have big claws, and they eat worms. So, do they dig up worms to share with the coyotes?
That's good thinking. And you're really close. Do you have other ideas?
Do they maybe catch animals underground? Like the coyotes catch animals that run fast?
Good thinking, Webb. That seems right to me.
You got it. So if an animal, a badger or coyote, wants to eat, escapes into a tunnel, the badger can chase after them and catch them. Then they share their food with the coyote.
Whoa, that's so cool.
Isn't nature awesome? There are so many kinds of animals with different body parts and habitats, and sometimes animals can use their skills to help others around them. So Bill and Webb, thanks to what you learned about mutualisms, is there any way you can build a boat together?
Well, I'm good at measuring and using tape, so I know how to make boats that are really sturdy.
And I'm good at decorating and making things look nice. So maybe if we use both of our skills, we can make the best boat ever.
Sounds fun. Thanks for your help, Mr. Brown.
It was my pleasure. I'm glad you learned something, and I'm excited to see your boat when it's done. And thanks for joining us, everyone. If you want to keep learning and having fun with me, Jesse, and all our other friends at the fort, be sure to hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you next time.
Bye!